coconut oil. Some people say it's a healthy fat. Some people even call it a superfood. Others say it's bad for your heart. So what's true and what's marketing? Let's crack this nut. One thing you'll hear very often is that coconut oil is very high in saturated fat. And that's true. Coconut oil is about 80 or 90% saturated fat. It's higher than even butter. Butter is like 60-something percent. And saturated fat in general tends to raise cholesterol, LDL cholesterol. So that's one source of concern. But saturated fat isn't all created equal. There are different types. So one thing you'll hear a lot on social media and different websites is coconut oil is okay because it's high in these special saturated fats called medium chain triglycerides, or MCTs. And it is totally true that MCTs are different from other types of saturated fat. MCTs have a carbon chain of 6 to 10 carbons, and they are absorbed and metabolized differently. They go straight to your liver, and they don't affect your LDL. They're kind of neutral when it comes to your cholesterol levels. So the ones we worry about as far as heart disease are longer saturated fatty acids, 12, 14, 16 carbons, that do raise your LDL. So what's the truth about coconut oil? Well, coconut oil does include some of these MCTs, but true MCTs are about 13% of the fats in coconut oil. Most of the fats in there and most of the saturated fats in there are longer saturated fatty acids. Lauric acid, which has 12 carbons, is the majority of the fatty acids in coconut oil. And lauric acid behaves in the body like a long chain fatty acid. It's absorbed like longer fatty acids, and it does raise LDL. And then coconut oil has quite a bit of longer, even longer than lauric acid, saturated fatty acids, things like palmitic acid and myristic acid, which also raise LDL. Now, all this stuff so far is biochemistry. It's good. We should look at it. But at the end of the day, what we want are direct tests. People eating coconut oil, does their LDL go up or not? And most studies and most meta-analyses find that coconut oil does raise cholesterol, both total cholesterol and LDL cholesterol, when compared to liquid plant oils. So unsaturated plant oils, things like olive oil or canola oil, but it raises LDL less than butter. The increase is about 10 milligrams per deciliter, 10 points compared to liquid plant oils. Not every study agrees. I've seen one meta-analysis that found no significant increase in LDL with coconut oil. And this discrepancy is probably because the effect isn't massive. It's 10 points. It's intermediate, right, between the liquid oils and the butter. And so it depends how much you're having and your genetics and other factors. Now, LDL is relevant, but it's an imperfect marker. Sometimes it gets it wrong. A better marker of heart disease risk is ApoB. We have a lot less data, a lot fewer trials that looked at ApoB with coconut oil. We do have a couple, though. So one trial, for example, found that coconut oil did significantly increase ApoB compared to safflower oil, which is an unsaturated liquid vegetable oil. So it does seem to be able to raise ApoB compared to liquid plant oils. So it's a good idea to keep an eye on your ApoB if you consume substantial amounts of coconut oil. And this is the good thing about these metrics, is you can measure your own and know exactly where you are as opposed to the average in a study. You can measure your LDL, you can measure your ApoB, and know exactly where you sit. Okay, measuring ApoBs and things like that is great, but at the end of the day, what we want to know is actual outcomes, heart attacks and strokes, heart disease itself. Does that go up or down or sideways? And we don't have much evidence as far as coconut oil and those hard outcomes of heart disease. That's a big gap. It's a question mark. People sometimes point to certain indigenous populations, Pacific Islanders, who consume a lot of coconut and who don't have high risk of heart disease compared to Westerners, for example. And they say, well, coconut seems to be fine. Two problems with that. One is that they usually don't consume the coconut oil that we consume. They tend to consume more whole forms, the coconut itself. And the other problem is there's 1,000 differences between those islanders and someone living in Chicago. They don't eat junk food. They don't sit around all day looking at electronic devices. They don't smoke, blah, 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 blah. So we can't get to cause and effect specifically of coconut oil with that type of correlations. We need more rigorous studies. So yes, I think the fact that coconut oil can raise ApoB compared to liquid oils is a valid concern. Although we don't have the definitive evidence. We don't have the hard outcomes for heart disease to really know if coconut oil increases risk of heart disease or not. But wait a second. Coconut oil may raise your LDL and maybe even your ApoB, but it also raises your HDL, the good cholesterol. You will often hear this or see this in websites, things like Healthline, and it's true. Coconut oil can raise your HDL. Some men has estimated an increase of about 4 points in HDL compared to liquid vegetable oils. But the question is, so what? If you're a regular viewer of this channel, you already know that HDL is not a reliable metric of heart disease risk. So something just raising your HDL per se is not that useful. We have a lot of studies on HDL, and our current understanding of HDL in heart disease in this field is that the effect on cardiovascular disease of a food cannot be judged from changes in HDL. HDL correlates with the healthy things like more exercise, leaner body, weight loss, but HDL per se doesn't provide any protection. And so a food increasing HDL doesn't tell us much about actual heart disease risk. Okay, the next idea you'll hear is that coconut oil can help you lose weight. There are a number of studies showing weight loss benefits, but most of those are not with coconut oil itself. They're with MCT oil. So it's an oil where MCTs have been purified. And coconut oil, as we said, contains some MCTs, but it's not the same concentration, it's not the same composition as these MCT oils. So we can't really make that leap. The data on actual coconut oil in weight loss is a bit mixed. I've seen one meta-analysis that found some reduction in body weight, modest, about 2 pounds. It's not nothing. Another meta-analysis found no significant effect of coconut oil for body weight, waist circumference, or body fat. So it's possible that it has an effect, particularly if you find coconut oil very satiating, you have some and you're not hungry for hours and you avoid eating a bunch of other hypercaloric stuff. Maybe it can help you with some weight loss. In general, the average we see for populations doesn't seem to be game-changing by itself. And then other metrics, studies have looked at that as well. In general, no significant effect either way of coconut oil on glucose levels, inflammation, or blood pressure when compared to liquid vegetable oil. Another claim you'll hear out there is that coconut oil has antimicrobial properties. So it can help you fight bacteria. It can help your immune function. This mainly comes from some lab data looking at test tube or petri dish data or mouse data with either coconut oil or some of its constituents isolated. So it's interesting data, but we can't make the leap to a human being actually eating coconut oil. As far as actual human data, there's a couple of interesting preliminary trials. There's one small trial in patients with COVID given coconut oil, and their inflammation seemed to come down faster. There's C-reactive protein, which is an inflammatory marker. There's another trial, also patients with COVID, where their symptoms seem to improve faster when given coconut oil, although it was a trend that didn't reach statistical significance. So it is possible that coconut oil has some antimicrobial, maybe some anti-inflammatory effects, maybe in specific contexts. We don't know. It's early to be sure. Another claim you'll hear out there, and it is interesting, is the effect of coconut oil on brain health, that it can improve your cognitive function. This comes from the fact that MCT oils can promote the increase of ketone bodies and ketones that are an alternative brain fuel. So the brain typically uses glucose. If we don't have glucose, it can use ketones. And there are a couple of smallish trials suggesting a benefit of coconut oil for cognitive function, specifically in patients with Alzheimer's. So it's possible that it has a benefit, whether it's specific to people with the condition or if it's general, we don't know. I think we need a larger trial to really nail this yes or no and put this on the map. But it will be very cool if coconut oil can have this type of benefit. Then we have claims pertaining to applying coconut oil in different parts of the body topically, right? Putting it on you, not eating it. So skin, applying coconut oil to your skin, there is some evidence that coconut oil can help moisturize your skin. And then for specific conditions, for example, children with something called atopic dermatitis, which is a skin condition, there's some evidence that coconut oil can help there, possibly through this moisturizing function because it helps with dry skin, which is a feature of atopic dermatitis. Another popular use is what's called oil pulling, where coconut oil is used sort of as a mouthwash to gargle or to swish around the mouth for oral health, for the teeth, for the gums, but not necessarily consuming it. And there is some evidence that it may help with oral hygiene, reducing bacterial counts, reducing plaque in the mouth. So possibly that antimicrobial effect that we looked at when directly applied to bacteria, it has an antibacterial effect, doesn't necessarily pan out eating the coconut oil and then affecting your immune system and in general to fight an infection. That's another story. And finally, for hair, applying it to your hair, there is some evidence as well that coconut oil or coconut oil-based hair oils can help strengthen hair by some measures. So to summarize the pros of coconut oil, there's some interesting preliminary data for brain health and for immune function, possibly in specific contexts. There might be a modest effect on weight loss, TBD, and also the topical application, skin, mouth, hair may provide some benefits there. And then the cause of coconut oil are the elevation of LDL, ApoB, and a possible not confirmed elevation of heart disease risk. So that's a summary of what we know about health effects of coconut oil so you can make your own informed decision. I can share what I do. I generally favor fats that have a lot more evidence documented of benefit. Mainly, I use olive oil and some canola. But the truth is, if someone wants to consume some coconut oil, especially if their lipids look good, we don't have a ton of evidence to tell them to do otherwise. And especially if the swap is swapping some butter with coconut oil, it's very possible that it may be an upgrade. If you're curious about canola oil, if you've been told it's poison on the internet, but no one's actually shown you the health effects in human beings, we have dozens of studies. We went over all of it in this video. Check it out. I'll see you in there.